neighbor's bed.
How are you? Welcome to Sesame Street. Am I glad you're here, because the Count is just putting the final touches on his painting, and then he's going to show it to us.
Ha-ha! There.
Yes.
Ha-ha! At last, my masterpiece is finished. Ha-ha! It is brilliant. A work of genius.
That's great. Can we see it now, Count? Is it okay?
Oh, of course you may see it. Okay. Yes, feast your eyes on this. Be careful, there's still some wet paint.
Oh, okay.
I call it 5 beautiful bats.
You mean 5 beautiful cats, Count. This is a painting of cats.
That's where you're wrong, my friend. Yes, it is a picture of 5 bats.
I don't see any bats.
That's the beauty of it. If you want to see the bats, you must find the bats. And while you find the bats, I, the Count, shall count the bats. I told you it was brilliant.
Oh, okay, you found one already? Did you?
Yes.
Okay,
that's one
at a time.
Bat.
Who found the first one? Right there?
No, I found the first one.
Okay.
Wait, there's one here. Yes, that's another one. That's 2 bats.
I found that bat.
Oh. Yes, that's 3 bats.
Did you find another one?
4 bats,
oh,
yes,
Dad,
4
bats. That's
another bat. I don't think so. Is that a bat?
Yeah.
Yes, that's it. That's 5.
Turn
5
right
beautiful bats.
Oh, that's wonderful. There are 5 bats in there. How about that? Hey, by the way, Count, when did you take up painting?
Oh, I've dabbled in it for years. Would you like to see more of my work?
Sure,
yeah,
you have more?
Yeah.
Would you like to see more?
Yes, right here on the easel.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right on the easel here.
Can I take
it off? Okay. It's another one from my bat period.
Your bat period?
Yes, I call it 500 bats at midnight. You see the bats?
Do you see bats?
Yes, oh, there's one. You pointed right at one. You're very good, Bob. Yes, that's 1 bat there. And in the corner opposite, yes, there's another one in the corner. Yes, there's 2 bats right in the middle. Right
Bobby,
in the middle.
No,
that's
bat,
one of my
no
favorite
bat.
Bats. I'm going to
no
call
bat,
him Bobby
no
Bat. That's 3 bats. Yes, another bat. Oh, yes, right there.
That's
you found him. That's 4 bats. Yes, wonderful. There's another bat. Yes, 5 bats. Another bat right in the...
A good day, everyone. I am a worm. Worm begins with this letter, W. It's really the only important thing that does, you know. Except, of course, for walrus. And water.
I was working the day shift out of robbery when the call came in. My partner Ben got it. My name's Sergeant Thursday. I'm a policeman.
Our witnesses say the guy we're after looks like this.
Okay. He shouldn't be too hard to pick up with that line down here. This line up again, then down again, then up again. Name's W.
Yeah.
Okay, let's go. Hold it, Ben. Look over there.
Let's check him out.
Nope, this guy has one line with some bumps. The guy we want has those 4 up and down lines.
Yeah.
Hold it, Ben. Look there.
That's him.
Let's check it out. He's got one line down.
And one line up.
And one line down.
And one line up. That's the W, all right.
Okay, I'll handle this. Excuse me, but are you the letter W?
What's it to you?
We're police officers. We'd like a word with you.
You see, there must be some mistake, officers. I'm an M, see? But if I see a W anywhere, I'll tell him you're looking for him, huh? So long.
So long.
Seems like a nice guy, that M.
Yeah. Let's see that sketch again.
Here it is.
Okay, the letter W. One line down, one line up. One line down.
Hey.
You.
Hey, you.
Come back here.
Come back.
Wait a second.
Hold on there. We'd like to talk to you
again. Come back here. You. Letter. Stop.
Somebody stop that letter.
Hold that letter.
You just eat me up.
Agua. Agua.
Edith Ann?
Yeah.
Do you ever do anything that makes you feel proud?
Yes, Harry, I do. Like yesterday, for instance, I went roller skating, and my dog Buster came with me. Only he didn't roller skate, because Buster don't like to roller skate. But he ran with me while I roller skated. He was right beside me the whole time. And you know what I did?
No.
I roller skated down a whole block without falling down. Yes. And I got very proud of myself. I felt so proud. And it was like somebody was blowing a balloon up inside of my body. And the balloon just kept getting bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. And then Buster was proud of me, too. And he was jumping around and barking. And he got so excited that he jumped right up on me and knocked me down and popped my balloon.
Oh.
Yes. The next time I go roller skating, I think I better take along an extra balloon in case Buster gets proud of me again. I want to stay proud of myself. And that's the truth.
That's nice.
Next clue.
Away from.
Next clue.
So come, get ready for me. Children of the world, so many years to grow, so many miles to travel, so many joys to know, with different hands reaching, holding fast, saying to the world, here we are together at last.
The rabbit and the turtle had a race to see who could get to the top floor first.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27. 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40.
Now then, we are going to have a lecture today about cookies. Cookie Monster. I'm doing a lecture about cookies. I'd appreciate it if you'd be very quiet.
But I need cookies.
No. Shh. Lecture time. Okay. Now, first of all, we're going to talk about the things that are different about these cookies. Now, you take a cookie like this one right here. Now, this cookie here is sort of shaped like a circle. You see this cookie? It's all round like a circle. You see that? No corners, no sides. It is a circle. All right, that's one. Now, let's take a look at this cookie right here. This cookie has four sides and four corners, and all the sides are the same length. So what do we call this? We call this a square. Right, Cookie Monster?
Oh, yeah. Oh, cookie.
Okay.
Cookie.
Yes, no. Just hold on. Now then, this next shape cookie right here, this one is shaped like a what? Everybody know what this shape is? This is a triangle, right? It's got three corners and three sides, so it is a triangular shaped cookie. Okay?
Oh, cookie.
Yes, now quiet. Now this last cookie over here, this one has four sides also, but it has two long sides and two short sides. So we call this one...
Delicious.
No, we call it a rectangle. A rectangle, that's what this kind of cookie is called. And now you know how all these cookies are different from each other. Isn't that amazing?
It boggled the mind.
Okay, now... But now I'm going to tell you what's the same about all these cookies.
Oh, Ernie, me no can take this. Me so hungry for cookie.
Well,
we got to go eat.
Okay, what's the same about all these cookies is that they're all for you to eat, Cookie Monster.
What?
Lecture's over. Help yourself.
Oh, Ernie. You give best lectures me ever tasted. Cookie!
Nom, Word here. Yeah. Do you know what that says?
Yeah.
What?
Help.
Help. That is help. Right there. Help.
Yeah.
What does that mean?
It means that if somebody if says help, I'll come and help them.
Uh-huh. And what if I yell, help?
I would come and help you.
What if I yelled three times, help, help, help?
I would come and help you again.
Oh, that is nice. And if you saw this sign.
Yeah.
And somebody was holding the sign.
Yeah.
Like Grover is right now.
Yeah.
What would you do?
I would help them.
Would you hold the sign for me?
Yeah.
That would be a help.
At 6 o'clock, I roll my truck out into the street. The morning sun is shining on the trash that I will meet. There's broken dolls and rubber wheels, TV sets and orange peels, baby rattles, paper plates, newspapers and rusty skates. Ooh, keep on trucking. Got to sort it, shred it, burn it to ash. There's a lot of hard work when you're working with trash. Take it to the terminal, dump it on a barge. Put it someplace that's awfully large. Ship it to a landfill where it decays. Cover it with dirt and make a park. Someday, you got to compact it, compress it, recycle, make less of it. You got to compact it, compress it, recycle, make less of it. Ooh, keep on trucking. Ooh, that's the garbage man's blues. We're running out of resources, running out of space. We don't have room for all that waste. We gotta compact it, compress it, recycle, and make less of it. There's a million things that garbage can do. Recycling saves energy too. Ooh, keep on trucking. Ooh, that's the garbage man's blues. Ooh, keep on trucking.
Witch. Which of these witches is whistling of oars? And which of these witches is not? If only one witch is whistling of oars, then the other is certainly not. Witch.
And now, I, the amazing Mumford, will pull a rabbit out of this hat. First, I wave my magic wand and say the magic words, a la peanut butter sandwiches. Nothing. This trick never works. Oh, I'm so embarrassed. I'm the only magician I know who can't pull a rabbit out of a hat. And do you know why I can't pull a rabbit out of a hat? No, of course you don't. Well, I can't pull a rabbit out of a hat because I don't have a rabbit. That's why, if only I had a rabbit.
Hey, did you get it? Oh, hey, ho, hi, how you doing? Did I hear someone call for a rabbit?
Yes, I did.
Oh, Professor D. Rabbit, at your service. What can I do for you, magician?
Well, I am the Amazing Mumford, and I need a rabbit to pull out of my hat.
Oh, yes, the old rabbit in the hat trick. I remember that one. I worked for a magician once. Used to pull me out of a hat seven shows a day.
Oh, that's marvelous. You've had experience. I can pull you out of a hat.
No. Sorry, Mumford. I gave up show business a long time ago. It was getting so hard on my ears.
Oh, please, just once. I only want to do this trick. I only want to do it once. I've wanted to do this trick all my life. You can't let me down, please.
I tell you what I'm going to do. I'll make you a deal. I'll let you pull me out of the hat on one condition.
What's that?
Afterwards, you have to let me pull you, out of the hat.
You want to pull me out of the hat?
Well, yeah, it's something I've always wanted to do all my life. What do you say, Mumford? Is it a deal?
Well, okay, yeah, all right, yeah.
Oh, good, thank you.
Go get ready. Okay. And now, I, the Amazing Mumford, will pull a rabbit out of this hat. First, I wave the magic wand and say the magic words, a la peanut butter sandwiches. Oh, that was wonderful, Professor. Thank you so much.
Well, think nothing of it. Now it's your turn, Mumford.
You're not serious about that, are you?
What? I certainly am.
Oh, do I have to?
Oh, come on, Mumford. We had a deal, didn't we?
Yes, okay. A deal's a deal.
Oh, good. Okay. And now, for the first time ever, a rabbit will pull a magician out of a hat. A la peanut butter sandwiches. Oh, oopsie-daisy, oopsie-daisy. Ah, thank you.
This is really embarrassing. I hope the Magician's Union doesn't hear about it.
Agua. Da vida a los humanos. Agua. Da vida a los animales. Agua. Da vida a las plantas. Agua. Todo el mundo necesita agua.
Yo soy fuego y yo no necesito agua. ¡Ay! ¡Agua!
A veces,
trabajamos muy bien juntos.
I love your funny face, your sunny, funny face, for you're cutie with more than beauty. You've got a lot of personality and tea. You fill the air with smiles for miles and miles and miles. Though you're no Mona Lisa, for worlds I'd not replace your sunny, funny face. You're much, too much. If you can cook the way you look, I'd swim the ocean wide just to have you by my side. Oh, you're no Queen of Sheba, for worlds I'd not replace your sunny, funny face.
Now, let's all play What Happens Next?
Hello, and welcome to What Happens Next, the game show where you have to find out what happens next. And now, for our first mystery situation. You'll notice there's a banana peel on the ground. Going to happen next? Do you think that you can tell? If you know what's going to happen next, then tell me before I ring the bell, before I ring this dinger's ding-dong bell. Well, what do you think? You say that our friend here is going to step on the banana peel and slip and fall down? Let's find out. Well, if you guessed that our friend would slip and fall down, you are absolutely right. But let's see if you're just as good at the next mystery situation. Our friend here is about to sit on that park bench. But if you'll notice, the bench has only one, two, three legs. Going to happen next? Do you think that you can tell? If you know what's going to happen next, then tell me before I ring the bell, before I ring this dinger's ding-dong bell. Well, what's that? You say that our friend here is going to sit on the bench and the bench is going to fall? Well, let's find out. Well, if you guessed the bench would fall, then you are absolutely right. You guys are great at this game. But our friend here is now getting ready to read the newspaper. But, and this is our last and final mystery situation, will our friend be able to read it? To happen next? Do you think that you can tell? If you know what's going to happen next, then tell me before I ring the bell, before I ring this dinger's ding-dong bell. Well, What's that you say? You think that our friend here is going to get all wet? Hmm? Well, let's find out.
Good night, Gerald. Good night, Sparky.
Good night, Sparky.
Good night, Mom. Good night, Dad. Good night, Sparky.
Imagine me an alligator.
There's an alligator in my room.
I don't see an alligator.
Well, sure, it's not there now, but when you turn out the light, it's there.
Go to sleep, Gerald. It's just your imagination.
Sweet potato.
Alligator. Mom!
What is it?
An alligator. It's back.
Go to sleep, Gerald.
And you came by for me to munch on. I'm afraid of getting dinner. Won't you please become my dinner?
Sparky, it was you all the time.
What is that singing?
Well, nothing, Mom. Just your imagination.
We take you now to Kermit the Frog with another fast-breaking news story.
Freddy, your reveneurs know about all this stuff. Hi-ho, Kermit the Frog here, and sci-fi fans, I'm speaking to you from the laboratory of a Professor Nucleus von Fischen, and I'm here to report one of the scientific marvels of the 20th century. Because, as you probably know, Professor von Fischen is the inventor of the fabulous $6 man. Ah. Who lays right here on the table, matter of fact. Yes. Is that right, Professor von Fischen?
Yes, that's right.
Mm-hmm. And this whole thing only came to $6, huh?
Yes, including tax.
Well, that's just incredible. The head, it looks like the head is made from a second-hand bowling ball.
Yes, that's right. Cost me $1.38 at the rummage sale.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And the hair up there is what, a scouring pad?
Yes, that's a scouring pad, 59 cents a package.
Uh-huh. Great. What's that nose?
Oh, that's a cork. Hmm. Cork was 25 cents, a real bargain.
That's very ingenious. And going down here, the body looks like it's an old olive oil can.
Yes, that was $1.59, but you got to remember there was a lot of olive oil came with it. I used that to lubricate the joints.
Oh, wonderful. The shoulder joint, matter of fact, is that's a hinge, huh?
Yes, those are some hinges I picked up for 10 cents each.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. How about the arm? What did you make that arm out of?
Well, the arms and the legs are drain pipes, and those were 50 cents a yard.
That's great. There seems to be a spoon here where the hand is, huh?
Spoons for hands. They were 35 cents a piece, yeah.
Oh, wonderful. And for feet, you've got spatulas, huh?
Yes, those were two for 79. That's a real bargain. I got those at a going-out-of-business pancake place over in Passaic.
Isn't it? And all of that comes to just $6, huh?
Yep, that's right. Oh, would you like to see me activate him?
Oh, we certainly would. That'd be just terrific, Professor.
Wonderful, yes. Oh, I got
ladies and gentlemen, this is a television first as we see the first demonstration of the $6 man.
Try again. There you go. You got to remember that he's steam drive. You know, it takes a little while to start him up. Once more. Hit. Yep, there he goes. There he goes.
Oh, wow.
Look at him go. Oh, marvelous.
Oh, my goodness.
Whoops. Did you see that? Oh, whoopsie daisy. Oh, look what happened.
Professor von Fischen.
Yeah,
you're a $6 man. Couldn't do anything. All he did was destroy your entire laboratory.
Well, what do you expect for $6?
One brightly beaked bird. Two brightly beaked birds. Three brightly beaked birds. Four brightly beaked birds. Five brightly beaked birds. Six brightly beaked birds. 7 brightly beaked birds. 8 brightly beaked birds. 9 brightly beaked birds. 10 brightly beaked birds. 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. No brightly beaked birds.
Don. 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 Don.
Yes, David.
See, what I was saying was that, yeah, I thought it was a good idea to have a little music in the store while people eat. I didn't mean for you to move your piano in.
My friend, we can worry about that later. Right now, I know just the kind of music your store needs.
Oh, you do?
You must remember this.
Right.
To call me irresponsible.
Okay, yeah, I get the idea. I get the idea.
The shadow of your... I left my heart.
Hey, Don. Don.
Yes,
Don.
Yes, David. It's perfect, isn't it?
Well, Don, I'm not sure.
Not sure?
Yeah, don't take it personally. I'm just not sure that...
Oh, I know. Don't tell me. The music I was playing is a little too soft.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, boy.
You want people who come to eat at the store to enjoy themselves, not fall asleep.
Right.
How about this?
Don!
Yes, David, you love it, don't you? I knew you would.
Well, let me just say, it's a nice song, and the arrangement needs a little work.
Of course, I know, don't say it. It's a little too loud.
Yes.
I mean, that kind of music makes you think of cheering and ball games and parades. You want your customers to think about, well, food.
That's, I guess so. That's
well, it. Why didn't you say so? I have just what you need. Direct from their highly successful tour from around the block. Here they are, the Sesame Street Cooking Choir.
Cooking Choir. Oh, great.
Ready, guys? A 1 and a 2. When David starts to cook, he chops, chops, chops. When David likes to cook, he chop, chop, chops. Till his tummy's flat. When David likes to cook, he stir, stir, stir. Stir, stir, stir. Stir, stir, stir. When David likes to cook, he stir, stir, stir. Till his tummy's flat.
I got it, I got it.
When David likes to cook, he'll mash, mash, mash. Mash, mash, mash.
Yes.
Mash, mash, mash.
When David likes to cook, he mash, mash, mash.
Well, David, that'll make your customers think about food, won't it?
I don't know, but I tell you one thing, they will not be thinking about eating.
Eating? Eating?
Eating.
Why, I know just the thing to make them think about eating. When people come to eat, they chew, chew, chew. Chew, chew, chew. Chew, chew, chew. When people come to eat, they chew, chew, chew. Till the chewing's done. When people come to eat, they swallow, swallow, swallow.
Swallow, swallow,
swallow, swallow. Swallow, swallow, swallow. When people come to eat, they swallow.
All I had in mind was a little tape.
Today, I'm going to tell you about the letter R. R is for rooster, and rubber, and rake. It's also for river, and make no mistake, it's even for rowboat, and rocks, and for rain, that causes the robber to go down the drain. Very well, what letter have we learned about today?
Arr.
Good heavens, a talking dog.
Okay. Oliver, what do you want? Oliver, what do you want? A seatbelt.
What do you want?
No, but you know, seatbelt, safety, seatbelt.
Seatbelt? No! Oh, seatbelt!
Seatbelt!
I'm out!
Seatbelt.
Seatbelt, 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 seatbelt.
Ah, seatbelt. Safe.
Safe. Forward!
Ice.
Boxes, peanut butter and jelly sandwiches.
Hi there. I got this great joke here, see? I come up behind some guy, and then I say to him, hey, you want to see something funny? And then, before he turns around, I hold this mirror up, so when he does turn around, he sees his own face. Oh, there's the guy. I'll try it on right now. this is going to be funny. Excuse me, you want to see something funny?
What? Funny? I don't see anything funny. What's so funny about that?
Huh?
Oh, yeah, now that's funny. Oh, is that funny?
That's really funny. Oh.
Show me what to do. But now I'm turning by myself and push and walk right through. Ooh, whoa, whoa, whoa. And there are other things I do I couldn't do before. Like help my mother fold the clothes and sweep the kitchen floor. And I can dress alone and do the buttons by myself. I make the elevator move, I drive it up and down, and I can make a big bus stop and let us off downtown. Ooh, whoa, whoa, whoa. I give the dog his supper and pour milk for the cat. Throw me a ball, I almost can hit it with a bat. It's not so easy, and I guess that I already know. Ooh, whoa, whoa, whoa.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Eight buttons. Eight.
Good. Very good. Great. What's wrong with it?
I don't know. It just doesn't work.
Great. Now what are we gonna do?
I don't know what you're gonna do, but you already did wake up an old owl.
I'm sorry, Hoots. We didn't mean to wake you up.
Not to worry, little darling. Well, it's just time for me to wake up anyway. The night is falling and the music's calling. So what's happening?
Okay, well, we wanted to practice for our dance contest, and now our tape recorder doesn't work.
It's kind of hard to practice dancing without music.
Hey, be cool, my fine, featherless friends. You got Hoots, don't you know? And when you got Hoots, you got music.
You mean you want to play for us?
Well, why not? I blow, you dance, huh? It's called cooperation, sweet thing. Cooperation. Now, give a listen to this. Something wrong?
Well, yeah. I mean, we can't dance to that. We need something that goes a little bit faster, like, okay, one, two, three, one.
Go, go, go. Okay, I got it, baby. Okay. I'm tuned into that. You want something that goes, sort of like this.
How come an old bird like you knows how to play music like that?
Well, Sam, my man, even an old bird can groove, you dig? So come on, cats, get out your scissors and cut me a rug!
What did he say?
I think he said, let's dance. Come on.
Beginning with R on me, and I'll show you some magic stuff.
Okay. Rabbit.
Rabbit. Keep it coming.
Rocking. Rock.
Not bad, huh?
Radio. Rope.
Anything beginning with R.
Rat.
Keep it coming. Keep it coming.
Rip. Rain.
You better get under this umbrella, kid.
Okay, I'm ready. Rain!
You're wet!
There's nothing like sleeping out under the stars. Is there, Bert? Sure is different from Sesame Street. Isn't it, Bert? Ooh, listen to that. We don't hear that on Sesame Street. What do you think that is, Bert? Oh, Bert!
Where am I?
We're camping out, remember? Hey, listen, Bert.
Oh, yeah.
Bert? You don't hear that on Sesame Street. You know what that is, Bert?
Ernie, I just finished a 5-mile hike. I need my sleep.
No, but it's fun to guess, Bert. An owl!
Ah!
An owl, that's what that is, Bert. That's an owl. You know how an owl goes? Owl goes, hoo, hoo, just like that. That's an owl, Bert. That's what that is.
Oh, Ernie, please.
And listen. There's something else. Hey, Bert, do you suppose that's a bird?
Ernie, most of the birds are asleep. I wish I was a bird.
I guess you're right, Bert. Well, if it's not a bird, what is it? Bert?
It's a cricket. It's a cricket, Ernie. Please go to sleep. It's a cricket.
Oh, a cricket.
Yes.
Wow, you're a good guesser, Bert. The cricket. Listen, there's something else. Bert, does that remind you of anybody we know?
It's a frog.
Oh.
It's a frog.
Right, Bert.
Yeah.
Oh, I guess you're right, Bert. I guess that is a frog.
A frog, all right. Gee, there are a lot of noises here. Huh. Boy. Oh, great. Now I'm not sleepy. All I hear are those noises. Ernie, I could sleep before you pointed out those noises. Ernie? Ernie?
Buonanotte.
Oyasumi nasai.
Good night.
Lala selama.
Zhou tao.
Hello.
Good night. Good night. Good night.
Yes, night is my favorite time of day.
And the stars, they are so beautiful. Oh, they make me want to bow. I love to bow at the stars.
I love to count the stars. I can count and count and count them all night and never count them all.
But you know you can't really enjoy the night. Unless you bow.
Ridiculous. The night was made for counting.
Bowing.
Counting.
Bowing.
Counting.
But wait a minute. Why are we arguing? We both enjoyed a night, right?
Mm, yes.
So why don't we enjoy it together?
You mean?
Yeah, sure. You can count.
And you can bar. An excellent idea. And later we can go back to the castle. I'll show you my paintings. There's one called 500 Bats at Midnight I think will interest you.
Yeah, sure. Sounds great. But right now, I'm in the mood to bar.
And I am in the mood to count.
Bar.
One, two.
Bar.